a recipe from a book Penny got for her birthday. It's called Gruffalo Crumble and Other Recipes. So we're in the breakfast section, and like Penny says, we're going to be doing scrambled snake. I'm going to be making a toastie, and Penny will be making the scrambled egg. So we've got everything we need here, and so I'm going to read it out, and Penny's going to be doing it. So you're going to explain what you've got there?
So I've got beans, some, what's it called?
Coriander.
Some milk, a bowl and some scissors to cut the coriander off.
Our coriander's looking a little bit dead, but we've added some water, which is why it's in the purple bowl, and it should liven up a little bit after. So you need to start by cutting up the herbs as finely as you can. So how many do you think you should use?
Tablespoon.
Yeah, so how many of these do you think that is?
It's quite a few, isn't it?
Maybe
yeah.
About that much.
Okay, right, so I'll chop them off for you and then you can chop them
up. Can you put them in here?
Yeah. So first of all, you can chop them over here, over this thing. Remember, you don't want the stalks. Just chop that one for me. And then you can measure it after. So in the measurement... In the recipe, it actually says, so here you go, you can start. In the recipe, it actually says 2 tablespoons, but we're only going to be doing 1 because we think 2 tablespoons is a lot. So while Penny's doing that, I'm going to start mine. I'm just doing a ham and cheese toasty. Remember to get the stalks out after. Yeah? Just need it out. Are you okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
This one there?
Just because you...
Right.
A tablespoon.
Penny, do you want both sides buttered? Do you want it buttered inside?
Yes, please. Would you say that's a tablespoon?
What do you think?
I think that's a little bit more.
You think that looks okay?
You need to chop them a little bit smaller. Because in the recipe it says as finely as you can, and finely means as
smallly.
Why are you using scissors to cut the herbs?
Because it is easier, mostly. And because knives. I'm not quite sure. just because it's easier.
Maybe, but I think it might be because then you can get it finer. And like Penny says, I think it might just be easier to use scissors. Do you think it's easier, Penny?
Yeah, I think it's much easier.
Tell me once you've done that and I'll read out the next step. Get these ones? That's looking really good.
Yeah,
so
and
this
one needs a little bit more.
So
that's about half, so.
We want to be able to taste it, don't we?
Yeah.
So, got to make sure you have enough.
Sorry about this if it's taking a bit too long. It's just, I kind of take my time doing this.
Stop for refreshments, honey.
Yep.
If you're wondering who is recording, it is our mum, who is using her phone. Yeah, phone.
That's who you can hear in the background. And we're using fresh coriander. We've got the plant because we use coriander quite a lot, and when it's in a plant form, it lasts longer. So rather than buying it in a bag, like some people do, it lasts longer, and it was around the same price, just a little bit more or a little bit less, can't remember which one. But and so it lasts longer, and because we use coriander quite a lot, then it's quite good to have a plant. So, and we always use fresh because it just tastes better. So we never use, for our herbs, we never use the ones that come in the little bottles because we like fresh. Is that enough cheese, Penny?
Yeah, that's enough cheese. And, by the way, you don't have to use coriander. You can use another herb. It's just you need herbs and we had coriander, so we just decided to use coriander.
Chives would be nice.
Yeah, in the recipe it gives a few other ones you could do. It says parsley, chives, coriander or dill. Because in the recipe it just says 2 tablespoons of fresh herbs. It doesn't actually say which ones, and then it gives a few examples.
So I'm finished with that.
Is that enough, Penny? Right, so pop that in the bowl. Break the eggs into the bowl and pick out any pieces of shell. Oh wait, so I have an idea. To make it easier to see the shell, should we put the coriander in the tablespoon as much as we can of it? Get as much as you can of it out. So then if there's any shell, the green might confuse us, so it'll be easier to see. Yes, those little bits don't matter. So just leave that there. Careful you don't knock that. How many eggs are you using, Penny?
Five.
Is that enough ham, Penny?
Huh?
Is that enough ham?
Yeah, that's
two
fine.
Slices?
Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if it gets on your hands, just remember to, well, how do I say this? Wash your hands once you've done
we
it.
We washed our hands before and we also put our hair up. Always put your wash your hands before and put your hair up when you're cooking.
Oh, that's a massive show in there.
And obviously if you're using an oven or any type of cooking that's warm or dangerous, always ask an adult, make sure they know what you're doing.
I can't get it.
It is very hard. Mum had to help Penny. It's very hard to get shell out of egg because the egg's so slippery. Your finger moves the shell around, especially the smaller bits.
Actually, I don't actually think that's shell.
Really hard. Right, that's cooking. Put my things away. You need some bread, don't you? And the butter. Do you go help you? You can use the same bowl. Careful of that coriander. You can use the same knife as I did.
It's
going
to be this one.
Just get out a piece of ham. And the red light is on, but we don't actually listen to the lights because they're never actually right.
Go, that's the shell.
One more. Look how lighter that one is to them. That one's more of a yellow, and then they're orange.
That's because it was the lightest one out of the pack. So.
Oh yeah. Oh, what? Make sure you get it all in there.
These they got four that are actually full. You put them in now.
Right, you've done that. Right.
Put these in now.
Yep. Right, move the shells out of the way.
Next one.
Add the milk and salt. So.
Oh, we need to mix it.
Use a big spoon. So, and then. Shall I add the milk and salt in?
Yes.
So we need a tablespoon of milk and a pinch of salt, so that doesn't have to be exact. I don't think any of this has to be exact, but I guess a tablespoon of milk you could just add a splash in, but Penny wanted to do her little exact measurements. So a pinch of salt, we've got one of those grinders, haven't we, Penny?
Yeah.
And so how many spoons shall we say a pinch is?
Just one, because a pinch is not that much, is it?
There we go. Pinch of salt. Mix with a fork. Oh, doesn't matter, does it? A spoon is fine. Until all the yolks have broken and you have a smooth, pale, yellow mixture.
Did you say
all the yolks
smooth?
Are broken?
Wait, I didn't say this.
That's good.
Bit more.
Right, and then melt the batter in the butter in a pan over a low heat. So that's we need to clear our area a little bit now. So I'm just going to put that against there like that. So
lovely yellow mixture.
Glad you think of the food you're going to eat us sick. So let's get our pan out.
But obviously it kind of looks like what it's gonna look like, just it needs to be a little bit more scrambled.
Think that's a good one?
Yeah.
Alright, which one? This one?
Yeah.
Okay. Mum's just confusing me. So our hob's a little bit confusing. We have to use a lighter to light it. I can't remember why.
The ignition's broken. The electric ignition's broken.
Excuse me.
Don't forget to remind your viewers to get an adult to help them with.
I already said that. Remember, if you're using a pan or an oven, to make sure someone knows. I'm just going to check on the toasty.
And use the scissors to help you with adults as well.
Good.
That can be dangerous.
Does that look cooked enough for you?
Yeah.
So I'll just get that out before we do. Do you know how to put it on, Penny? The heat on, or do you want me to do it? I think it's better for me to do it.
Yeah.
Right, I'll just leave that. We can get this on so the butter can melt. So.
By the way, sometimes if it's on, like, make sure it's on, like, a small heat before you actually put it on, because you could burn yourself.
And what doesn't help is our lighter's not that good anymore. So,
excuse me. We need to get a new lighter.
So, what does it say?
We've got matches.
How high do you think we should have our heat?
A little bit lower.
There?
Perfect.
Right, so do you want to put a little bit of butter in? Come over here. Bring your little chair with you. Always make sure it's in the middle. Pop. How much? It just says a knot of butter, so I guess that's just a... However much you think, really, just a little bit of butter, and I'll get your toasty out. Get that knife.
A bit more.
That. Perfect. This? Yeah. That's good. Right. Oh, melted straight away. It's having a little ride in there, isn't it? Slipping everywhere. So. Right, so.
Wow.
And melt the butter in a pan over a low heat. Is that? Yeah, that's low. Tip in the egg mixture and cook until set, stirring continuously. So I think we need to mix the butter a bit everywhere first.
Does it say what we need to stir it with?
A wooden spoon, I'm guessing. Is that a low heat?
Yeah.
A little bit low. Right, so get a wooden spoon, because it's not good to use metal spoons when you're using them. Right, do you want to pour it in there?
Especially because...
Take the spoon out first.
Especially because it could burn and make a fire.
Put that in the wash. Remember, if you're going to ever use eggs and stirring continuously, so that means don't stop. So, if you're ever using eggs, if you come in contact with eggs, with your fingers or anywhere with you, you need to make sure you wash them, because eggs raw are not good for you.
Don't lick them.
That'd be a terrible idea.
See, now it's forming into actually scrambled eggs.
Yeah, it's a little bit gross, doesn't it?
Now it looks more like chicken. Chicken, you see that?
Right, so now I'll put you stir that, because remember we need to always be stirring it. We can't cut it. I think you probably shouldn't be using a butter knife to cut your toast, but you know what? I'm gonna do it.
You know what? Just then, I think you had like a little toasty tutorial.
So
just scrambled snake tutorial.
I need to put the toast in now, so you stir that.
Wow, that's actually scrambled egg.
There we go, that's ready. So, here, we've got, I think this is egg, so we need to make sure we wash that before anything touches it. So I'll do that once I've got my toast in. Oh, my. Right? Oh, Penny, that's. Can you smell it? Does it smell good?
Smells amazing. At least it doesn't look like sick now. Looks like scrambled egg, not sick anymore.
So I'll wash the rosemary. Turn it down a little bit.
We need to turn it off.
Right, is that done then?
I did it!
That looks amazing. So stir it a little bit more. Because obviously our pan's still hot, so it doesn't, when you turn it off, go cold straight away. So that's still going to be cooking a little bit. So that's why we had to turn it off a little bit early, because it's still going to be cooking. So
this smells amazing.
Should I get a plate, a bowl, sorry, for us to put it in?
Annie?
Yeah?
Annie? Do you think we'll be recording us actually eating it, seeing if it's actually nice?
Yay! Yeah? Right, think that's good?
Yeah, that's good. Right. By the way, if you were wondering, this feeds two people.
So I'll hold it, you spoon it in. Oh yeah, that looks so good.
Smells amazing as well. Toast as well, I think.
Put some toast in. Okay,
there we go.
We'll just put that there. In fact, I'm going to run that under the water because otherwise, you scrape that off. Because otherwise, when this dries, it's going to be harder to get off. So if I put warm water on that, it will get easier. Now, I'm not sure if all the steam is going to come up when I put the water under. So like always, if I'm doing pancakes or something, I always step back. Because when hot comes to cold, well, you'll see, maybe.
Like they say in class dismissed.
Oh, it didn't work.
Stand back, we're doing science.
That's what you're
going
around.
Two people. As I said.
So, are we just gonna. Right, so I think.
Looks delicious. Make sure it's not
toast isn't even ready.
Make sure it's not stuck together.
I'm going to try a bit now while we're waiting for the toast, so I'll try it while it's still warm.
Get some herbs as well.
Is that nice?
It's really nice.
That's really good. And on toast. Don't eat it all before we have the toast. That is really good.
Amazing.
Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed. See you
Bye.
Next time. Bye.